It's often been said the best present you can get for your car or truck is a hoist. I'm going to tell you all you need to know about a scissor hoist. First thing, you're limited by what type of hoist you can buy by the height and shape of your garage. This one's a little less than 9 feet, so I can't have one of those drive-on hoists. So, I've got to have a scissor hoist. What do I want it for? Do I want it for a truck or I want it for my car? And depending on the type of car you have, it's not going to be an issue. Well, maybe a little. The truck, it better weigh less than 6,000 pounds. Because this thing can lift 3 tons, 6,000 pounds. That's it. I have had full-size pickup trucks on it. It will work. What does it come with? It comes with 3 different pads, adapters that you can use on these swing-out arms. Okay, so it has a short little pad, then it's got the mid-height one and a bigger one that you use typically for trucks. And these just swing out of the way. And by the way, the arms, they move front and back. Anyway, let's get to the specifications of this thing. Let's get it on the ground. And let's check it out. Because one of the things you'll need to know if you have a sports car is, will your sports car get on this hoist? They actually say the hoist is about 4.5 inches, 4 3/4 inches high to drive over. But in my experience, Mercedes, BMWs, even a Toyota Corolla, I think, and of course my own car, Corvette C5, it won't fit on this hoist without hitting it. So you can't actually drive on it because it will not work out. Okay, so once the arms are down, this thing's all the way over, let's measure it and see exactly its highest point.
Outlet.
But I'd recommend the 110. Everybody has a 110 outlet in their garage already. I picked up full-size pickup trucks for this. Not a problem. Again, as long as pickup trucks under 6,000 pounds, most are. Like a Chevy Silverado is, 5,000, 5,300 pounds, something like that with nothing in it. So I can lift that, no problem. The dimensions, if you want to pick it up, this thing is a little over 8 feet. It's about 8 feet, 4 inches long. So you can put it in the back of a pickup truck bed as long as you have a tailgate now. And it's about 3 feet and 4 inches wide, something like that. 3 feet, 4, I think. So it's about 8 feet, 4 long. So you can pick it up and it'll fit in the back of a pickup truck. Now the power unit here is super easy to use. Super easy. It has a small button right there, and it has a handle. I'll get you a little picture close up here just to show you how it works. Okay, so you have three controls on this to operate the scissor lift. You've got the power button, you push that, it goes up just like this. It raises pretty quickly, as you can see. It goes to a height of about 54 inches with pads on it. Which is plenty to get under here and change oil. 90% of car work is brakes and suspension, inside the car, under the hood, and an oil change. Obviously a scissor hoist is not the best if you do a lot of driveline work. If you want to change the transmission and you want to change a drive shaft on a rear wheel drive truck or something, you can, but it's harder because obviously there's a lot of stuff in the way compared to a fork post hoist. To lower this is the lowering handle. You've got to release a lock. It has a lock on it, a safety lock, like all good hoists do. And it's this little motorcycle clutch handle. You pull up on it like that, and then you simply push the lever, and down she goes. And that's all there is to it. That's how you use it. Again, you need a 110 volt source close by. It comes with 8 or 9 feet or so of hose on it. But to use it, very simple, very easy. And down she goes. This is also used to move the hoist around. If you want to move it, one guy can do it. It's a heavy unit. This thing's not light. But you have a little pin in the bottom here. You just insert it like that, and you lift. And it's easier to do when the hoist is all the way up in the air. It's much easier to do. So it just balanced that way. It's just easy to move. You can do it. I moved it around myself, and I'm over 50, so I'm sure lots of people have no trouble moving it at all. So to sum up, this 6,000 pound scissor hoist is a great deal for a lot of people. I've had it for 3 or 4 years. It's been great. The only issue I had with it was that it was hitting the bottom of low cars. And my solution was just to use some 2x12s, 2x16s, and cut them and stain them and use those to raise the car, just drive up on them. They work great. So again, this thing will lift 6,000 pounds. It will lift the pickup truck. And it's a great solution. You can move it around. It's easy to move around. Works on 110. Don't need the 220. And one last thing. I find it has a lot of uses when there's a garage party. Anyway, thanks for watching Car Questions, and please subscribe.